My new book, The Gut-Brain Paradox, is almost here. And today I'm giving you an exclusive sneak peek at some of the most groundbreaking discoveries inside. All right, sneak peek number one. Your body needs dirt to stay healthy. For centuries, humans ate food straight from the ground, exposing their immune systems to tiny amounts of bacteria. Nature's allergy shots. But today, we sanitize everything like our life depends on it, and we're sicker than ever. Autoimmune diseases, food allergies, and even brain disorders are skyrocketing. Turns out our obsession with cleanliness might be the very thing wrecking our health. The hygiene hypothesis, or why being too clean is making us sick, is one of the reasons behind this. Now, our ancestors ate unwashed root veggies, microbes and all. This trained their immune system to tolerate bacteria instead of overreacting. In fact, there's a shocking study. Kids raised on farms where they're exposed to more bacteria have far fewer allergies and autoimmune diseases than their ultra-sanitized city counterparts. Now, there's even more. The brain-bacteria connection. Believe it or not, the lack of bacterial exposure actually weakens brain defenses. In fact, in a study on germ-free mice had leakier blood-brain barriers, making their brains more vulnerable to toxins and inflammation. But low-dose bacterial exposure actually resulted in less neuroinflammation. A really cool study showed that exposure to tiny amounts of bacterial compounds called lipopolysaccharides, LPSs, and if you've read my books, you know what LPS stands for, little pieces of, yes, you're right. LPSs train the immune system to stop overreacting, and it reduces brain inflammation and even protects against dementia. Now, here's a scary one. Antibiotics obviously kill bacteria, and as most of you know, antibiotics kill our gut microbiome. But do they have any effect on memory loss? Well, a study in middle-aged women who took antibiotics frequently showed faster cognitive decline just 7 years later compared to women who didn't take antibiotics. The good news from all this, you don't need to start licking the floor to fix this problem. Just a few easy tweaks can help reintroduce beneficial microbes into your life. But you have to read the book to find out what these tweaks are. All right, sneak peek number two. Your gut controls addictions. Your cravings are not actually coming from you or your brain or your bad behavior. They're actually coming from bad gut bacteria. Shockingly, certain microbes thrive on alcohol, nicotine, and even opioids, hijacking your brain's reward system to keep you hooked. Let me give you some examples. Alcohol in the gut. People who develop alcohol addiction have distinct gut bacteria years before their first drink. A 30-year study found that future alcoholics had unique microbiomes long before starting drinking. Now, here's a fascinating fact. Healing the gut during detox actually reduces cravings and relapse rate. In fact, in studies of people in rehab for alcohol, people who had the worst set of alcohol craving bacteria were the most likely to do poorly during rehab and relapse, whereas alcoholics who had the least mischievous alcohol-seeking bacteria were more likely to complete rehab and stay off drinking. So it's not you, it's not your weakness, it's them. How about smoking? Well, it turns out smokers have fewer gut bacteria that regulate dopamine production, making quitting much harder. In fact, Kids with low levels of key gut bacteria were more likely to start smoking than kids who had a better balance of gut bacteria. Now, the microbiome actually shifts after quitting to trigger food cravings to replace nicotine's dopamine boost. And that explains why most smokers, once they quit, gain a lot of weight, because they've shifted their microbiome to get their dopamine kick, not from nicotine and cigarettes, but from foods. Finally, opioids. Opioids, number one, cause gut damage. They cause leaky gut and chronic inflammation, worsening pain sensitivity and fueling addiction. Now, here's a fascinating study in mice. You can addict mice to opioids, and as they become addicted, they get a completely different gut bacteria that actually craves those opioids and starts benefiting and eating those opioids. How do they get more? They actually create more pain, more leaky gut, which requires more of the opioid. Fascinating study. You take those mice, you treat them with antibiotics to kill off their gut microbiome, and lo and behold, their cravings go away, and only little bits of opioids are needed to give them a high. Here's the bad news. If you repopulate that gut with those addictive microbiome, they once again have to have huge amounts of the same drug. Now, exciting news, in rehab for opioids, probiotics, friendly bacteria, actually reduced opioid withdrawal symptoms and craving. So the good news is, you don't have to fight addiction with willpower alone. In the book, I reveal how gut health is the key to overcoming cravings, including food cravings, improving mental health, and breaking the addiction cycle. So if you know someone struggling with addiction, depression, or uncontrollable cravings, please share this book with them. It could save their life. All right, sneak peek number three, the brain-boosting diet you've never heard of. Now, we all know diet affects brain health, but what if the type of protein you eat plays a major role in your mood, addiction recovery, and cognitive function? I reveal in the gut-brain paradox the chicken and the sea diet, my version of a safe carnivore diet. The good news, you don't have to go full carnivore or keto to support your brain. In the gut-brain paradox, I'll show you a few simple food swaps that can supercharge your gut to start healing quickly with the ultimate gut repair eating protocol. But you have to read the book to find out what they are. So if you found these sneak peeks fascinating, just wait until you read the whole book. More amazing episodes just like this one. Watch now. Your immune system, your white blood cells, tell all of your other cells in your body that there are issues.